He takes care of everything. You know, not the first story. We've had family, Ilka Stewart's. Her mother was longtime her technician. That is a level of trust you don't often find.
So as Paula Moltzan heads out, Maren Skjold of Norway has taken over the lead as Moltzan is just the 10th skier down of 30.
Paula Moltzan's first run, you know, if not for the big air, she would have been well up the ranks. And she said, after that first run, big opportunity here with a clean course. She expects to come down with a lead and a big one at that. And she's taking some risk.
Also spends time skiing for the University of Vermont. In fact, she won a college race just a week before coming to these worlds and hanging on to the top time thus far.
Busy schedule, a couple of turns in there. They're big across the fall line, right midway. It's where Nina Bryan had a little bit of difficulty, so you have to respect the line. You can't just go all out.
Moltzan from the same area in Minnesota as Lindsey Vonn, Buck Hill. And let's see if she can hang on, but not likely. She has slowed down quite a bit, and Skjold should hang on to the top time, but just behind her by 2/10. Moltzan says, pretty good. Maybe not my best, but not bad at all.
Paula told us after the first run she wasn't completely happy with the mistake she made, but what about that second run?
It was definitely better. Still had a couple mistakes on the bottom, but I'm definitely happy with my performance here at World Champs.
This is your first World Championship since 2015. As you look at the bigger picture, what's your takeaway from this event?
Sweden has some variable weather, that's for sure, but it's just a great experience. Every run you get on a new hill is a good day for me because you're going to build experience, build progress, and it's just been a good experience for me.
What does it tell you about where you are?
Kind of lets you know where you sit in the world. It's not completely off this, but it's a nice competition to see where you sit.
What's next for you? Back to college?
Yeah, back to school, and we have NCAAs coming up the first week of March.
All right, good luck.
Thank you.
Getting a lot of frequent flyer miles. Paula Moltzan, though, telling us exactly what we've been telling you, is that these conditions are very unlike what she has faced this year in the spring-like conditions. Paula Moltzan did a pretty good job.
This is Laurence St. Germain from Canada, who begins the final eight here to decide the women's slalom.
You can see the course workers out there during a commercial break, really trying to put the final touches on this course. It's really held together beautifully. Now the sun is out, so the visibility is perfect. Saint-Germain, one of three NCAA, active NCAA skiers out here at the World Championships, and she is the best of them. Having a good run right now. Big skier, you can see, you know, there's moments where she gets out of control, but she has what they call a nose for the fall line.
She attends the University of Vermont in the United States. 15th in the Olympic slalom a year ago, has lost some time, is about right on Uber's time right now. St. Germain comes across and indeed stays on top by 2/10. So the Austrians back up to second and third. Bernadette Skjold officially off the podium for Austria as they occupy spots 2 through 4.
What a season she is having. It is, what a contrast of style to the two Austrians that she just unseated. Couple of moments there where things got loose on her. Just holding her breath. A lot of load at each gate. You just kind of like a weightlifter. You hold your breath and you push against the ski.
In the final results, it is Schifrin by better than a half second over Sven Larsson of Sweden as the home country indeed gets that medal. Petra Vlova settles for the bronze, still caps off a fantastic World Championships. Linsberger of Austria just off the podium.